So now we're going to take a look at the newest component in the design system with an introduction to pagination. Pagination, which is navigation for paginated content. Pagination is a curious little component, one that started out seeming like a small project, just a few buttons with page numbers in a row, with previous and next buttons, like we see on the slide here, helping users move between numbered pages. And it is simple in its way, but within pagination is a lot of behavioral complexity. So today we'll hear from the USWDS core team about how we built this component and take a look at the component in action. Slide 13. So to introduce us to pagination, I'd like to welcome three members of the USWDS core team, Sophia Savkina, James Mejia, and Katie Klein. We'll start with UX and usability research with Sophia. Sophia, take it away.
Thanks, Yudan. Slide 14. Hello, everyone. My name is Sophia, and I am a user experience researcher on the US Web Design System team. There are several steps that go into creating a new design system component, and it was exciting to work through those steps with the team. We started by breaking down our UX research and design process into three phases: exploration, validation, and iteration. I will take you through each of these phases in detail. Slide 15, exploration phase. We started with landscape analysis, reviewing UX and design best practices for pagination and how other design systems and websites solve for presenting pagination content to users. We took what we learned and put our best assumptions into a prototype. Slide 16. This is the prototype we created to test with users. It's a standard search results page with five different results with descriptions underneath. At the bottom left-hand corner, there are four square buttons with numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. The first button is highlighted in blue link color and the rest are white. On the bottom right, there are two buttons with arrows indicating previous and next, and a clickable link with the text view all results. The desktop orientation is displayed on the left and the mobile layout on the right. In the mobile layout, the page looks more narrow and the pagination component at the bottom is simplified to the two buttons, previous and next. Slide 17, validation phase. This is where we took our assumptions and put them through several rounds of validations. We started by asking our Slack community of USWDS practitioners for feedback. This feedback helped us validate initial assumptions with experts and also helped uncover knowledge gaps. As a result, we were able to focus our research questions and chose the right method to answer those questions. Next, we took these research questions and conducted a focused usability testing of design and guidance content. This in-depth observation study allowed us to have deeper conversations with UX and visual designers to gain rich usability insights within the context of use. In addition, we asked for stakeholder feedback. We talked to the search.gov team, since they power the search technology for many agency websites. From that conversation, we uncovered additional use cases that were specifically applicable to .gov websites, such as unbounded datasets. Slide 18. Here is an example of how we analyzed user feedback for the component guidance, which we also tested as a form of content research. The image on the slide depicts a section of our data analysis board with a visual representation of the pagination guidance page. As we were going through user feedback, we annotated the guidance according to what we heard. The areas of clarity are highlighted in the text in green, and the areas of confusion are noted in red. We also added user insights on the sticky notes alongside the guidance and grouped them by themes. Slide 19. Including a UX designer and a content editor as observers at the testing sessions allowed our team to establish early learnings and alignment, as well as streamline the iteration process. Slide 20. One of the UX designers we spoke to in our usability testing told us this, quote, "Pagination is another form of navigation. It's kind of a context-specific navigation." Slide 21, iteration phase. We reviewed and discussed insights from usability testing as a team and made design and guidance improvements. Slide 22. On this slide, there are two iterations of USWDS pagination component. The top one is the first version that we tested with users. It features four gray page navigation buttons on the left side of the page, with the current page highlighted in the blue link color. Then on the right side of the page, a grouping with previous and next buttons with only an icon and a link view all results. Below is the version that we made based on findings from our usability testing. First, our revised version removes the horizontal gap between the page buttons and the previous next buttons. While this was a clean solution, we found it was more effective to keep all the controls together. We also try to reduce horizontal gaps in the reading order because some people, particularly those with low vision and using screen magnifiers, find it hard for their eyes to follow horizontal gaps. Next, we wanted to improve the core functionality of the pagination component, showing the current page and focusing on clear navigation actions. In our revision, we increased the number of page slots to 7 and made sure we always showed the first, last, previous, and next pages. We moved the previous and next buttons to before and after the page buttons, the position most users expect. We removed the view all results link to keep our component focused on essential features. We made the button borders less dark and made the backgrounds transparent to reduce the weight on the buttons and keep the focus on the page numbers. We made the current page button the same as the text color, black, to make it seem less like an active link. Lastly, though it is not shown here, we adjusted the mobile version to make it more consistent with the desktop version. Slide 23. By having a cross-functional team jointly review the findings of the validation phase, we were able to collectively make confident improvement decisions. And now I will hand it off to James, who will take you through the technical demo of the pagination component.
Thank you, Sophia. Hello, everyone. My name is James Mejia. I'm a developer on the USWDS core team. So now let's see pagination in action. We've prepared a search results page so we can demo the component in a more realistic example. If we scroll down to the bottom, we can see our new pagination component. Pagination has 7 slots available to display your pages. It's best practice to always display the first page, the current page, and the last page when available. We're using the default variant in this demo. This version is for more traditional data sets where you get a fixed number of results. In this case, we have 12 pages of results. If we were to have 7 or fewer pages in our data set, then we'd show all of the pages available within those 7 slots I mentioned. On small screens, we simplify the component by only displaying the page numbers. No previous or next links are visible. This is why it's important to show the first, current, and last pages when available. Let's take a closer look at a few states of pagination. This is the start of pagination on a small data set. I previously mentioned showing all pages if the total number of pages are fewer than 7. If I work my way toward the middle of this small data set, the first, the current, and the last pages are displayed and surrounded by the previous and next links. At the end of the small data set, the next link disappears. Note, for accessibility, we added a special ARIA label for the last page. It reads last page, comma, page 3 in this case. Now let's take a look at what pagination would look like for larger collections of pages, for example, more than 7. At the start of larger collections, we show the first 5 pages, an overflow element, an ellipses in this case, the very last page, and the next link. In the middle of this larger data set, we show the very first page, the overflow, the current page and its immediate siblings, another overflow, and the very last page surrounded by the previous and next links. Toward the end of the data set, we have the very first page, an overflow, and the last five pages with previous and next links on either side. The other variant, unbounded, isn't too different from our default. This variant is for unbounded data sets. Its use case is smaller than the default. If you want to show a lot of search results ordered by relevance, this would be a good fit. Its goal is to show as many pages as possible at the start of the data set. It looks similar to the default. However, instead of showing the very last page, like on the default, we show an overflow element to clearly indicate that there are more pages at the end. As you progress through the pages, you can see it's visually similar to the default. Our last example shows us progressing through to page 12 of an unbounded set of pages. Pagination has five available component settings. Theme pagination background color for accessible link color setting. We can see how this works by setting ink as a background color in our demo and updating the component's background color variable to ink. Once it finishes compiling, you should see the component update to adapt to the background color change, like so. The rest of the settings for pagination are pretty straightforward. Besides theme pagination background color, we have theme pagination breakpoint to determine at which breakpoint we show the full component, theme pagination button border radius, the roundness of the buttons, theme pagination button border width, the border width of the buttons, theme pagination font family, which is the font used in the component. I hope you found this technical demo useful and look forward to hearing your experiences with pagination. Now, Katie Klein will walk us through the pagination guidance. Thank you.
Slide 25. Thanks, James. My name is Katie Klein, and I am a content strategist working with the USWDS team. Now we'd like to walk you through the highlights of pagination guidance. There are several guidelines associated with using this component. Show the size of the paginated set. Users want to know the length of a section that has been paginated. This is most commonly accomplished by always showing the last page as the last item in the navigation. Users should also know if the set is unbounded and has no discrete length. For example, some large search results will not have a last page. The USWDS pagination component will always show the last page of the set as a navigable link, or show an ellipsis at the end of the links if the set is unbounded. Highlight the current page. It's important for the user to know where they are and what page they're on. Include the first, previous, and next pages. Users should always be able to navigate to each of these pages from any page in the set. Indicate any missing pages. Whenever there are pages missing between two elements, indicate the absence of these pages with an overflow indicator, like a non-selectable ellipsis. Slide 26. Use as few navigation items as possible. Focus on essential actions and avoid adding more items, like extra page buttons, to pagination just to fill space. Show navigation items in a single line. Pagination can be hard to understand, and individual items can be more difficult to select when the items break over one line. Avoid using pagination in any context where it would be more than one line long. Use generous touch targets. Use touch targets that are big enough to select with any finger and have enough separation to avoid mistakes. Optimize the number of entries per page. Consider page load, performance, and the user's scrolling preferences when determining how many items are displayed on each page. Some paginated content benefits from user control over the number of elements to show on each page. Slide 27. That was a high-level look at the usability of pagination, but we also have given careful consideration to the accessibility of the component. Here are some additional guidelines you should keep in mind as well. Pagination should be a nav element with a unique descriptive label. clearly identify pagination as a distinct navigation section to screen readers. Voice the current page with ARIA current. Using ARIA current on the current page's link ensures the current page's link item is voiced as the current page for screen readers. Assure that every navigation element is voiced as a page and that the last element is voiced as the last page. Provide as much context as possible to screen readers. Use a link for the current page for robustness. While it may sound counterintuitive to link to the current page in your pagination component, it makes sense to include this as a link, so screen readers voice the current page whether the user navigates by element or by tabbing. Avoid large horizontal gaps between navigation elements. Users with limited vision or using a screen magnifier may stop scanning and miss an element if there's too much horizontal space between one element and the previous element in the reading order. Slide 28. So when should you use the pagination component? There are a couple of common use cases for pagination. Search results. Pagination is most commonly used with paginated search results. Multi-page collections of related items. Common examples include articles related to a category or tag, content archives, and history or activity. Slide 29. And when should you consider something else? There are also cases in which pagination is not the best approach. Meaningful page groupings. Meaningful page groupings are more like sections or chapters. Use conventional navigation like side navigation. Steps in a sequence. If you need to indicate progress through a series of steps that must be completed in succession, like a multi-part form, consider using the step indicator component. Use this. And finally, short collections. If the length of the entire collection is less than 3 to 4 screen lengths long, consider showing all the items at once instead of paginating. Slide 30. This has been an overview of the usability, accessibility, and use cases of pagination. The full guidance for this component is available on our website at designsystem.digital.gov/component/pagination. Try it out for yourself and let us know what you find.